Thank you very much, Sheikh Zakaria Abdul Rahman, the Deputy Chief Imam.
Thank you very much, Most Reverend Daniel Yukar Safa.
Thank you.
to stand and pray at least for the reading of this address and presentation of awards.
Your Honor, March passed over. May I have your permission to stand and pray at ease for delivery of address and presentation of awards. Your Honor.
Of the struggle of successive generations of Ghanaian peoples to establish a free, sovereign Ghana. We are grateful that on such a happy day, leaders of our neighboring countries and friendly nations have joined all Ghanaians in our celebration. We welcome them and we say a power to each of them to Ghana. I thank the children from our capital of Kumasi for their excellent march. I thank the cultural troops and social groups present on their magnificent display, which are showcasing the best of Ghanaian culture. I salute to a great extent Adiza and her group, as well as the group from the special school. Our armed forces and security service are rightly celebrated across the region, the continent and the world for their professionalism and contribution to global peace and security. I thank the officers and the men and women of the Ghana Armed Forces, the police service, prison service, fire service, immigration, and all other security services for their display of other pomp and ceremony. And I thank them all for their willingness to put their lives on the line to secure our domestic peace, tranquility, and the sanctity of our property. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm happy to announce that His Excellency the President has performed a religious duty this morning before attending the parade in Accra as a gesture of thanksgiving to the Almighty God for the blessings He has showered and continues to shower on our nation. Being independent means you have the freedom and ability to make informed decisions in life without having to ask other people for permission. Help or make money, and then you take full responsibility for seeing things through. Our founders chose this day, March 6th, as the date of our independence in order to repudiate the bond of 6 March 1844, which led to our land becoming a British colony. 53 years later, in 1897, 120 years ago, a group of our forebears was moved to start a campaign against the terms of the colonial relationship between what was then the Gold Coast and the United Kingdom. Nananom, if the signing of the bond of 1844, now the formal start of the Gold Coast colony, then the formation of the Aborigines Right Protection Society on 4th of August 1897 in Cape Coast marked the start of the struggle for political independence. It is worth mentioning some of the names of the members of the society because, unfortunately, we have not often acknowledged their role. John Mens Asawa, Joseph S. Lehifort, J.W. Say, J.P. Brown, and their colleagues, who mobilized the chiefs and people against the Crown Lines Bill and forced the colonial authorities to retreat. Saba began the tradition of the Ghanaian lawyer as a nationalist. This was probably one of the most dramatic interventions in the colonial history of our country. 120 years after the event, insignificant might be lost on us. The very same objectives of the Crown Land Bill were introduced at the same time and became law in countries like Kenya, Zimbabwe, Zambia, and other British colonies around Africa, and changed the course of their history. The lands of the indigenous people were seized by the British Crown under that law, an event from which a century later they have so not recovered. In what was then the Gold Coast, our lands remained ours because of the bravery of the members of the Aborigines Right Protection Society, and we must pay homage to these agents every day, especially on the 60th anniversary. Even though we established and secured in 1897, the continuing and inalienable rights to our lands, we remained a colony and could not govern ourselves. The next significant event in the struggle occurred on August 4, 1947, exactly 50 years later to the day of the formation of the Aborigines Right Protection Society, when a group of nationalists gathered in Saltmore for the launch of the United Gold Coast Convention, the UGCC, the first political party in our country. The founders of the UGCC then met to demand independence from the British, and 70 years after that event, one still marvels at the clarity of thought and the passion that they displayed. Some of the names of that momentous day have survived in our written history and folk memory. Five of them are on Ghanaian currency: Joseph Wachi Dankwa, Emmanuel Obechevi Lamte, William Ofuriata, Ebenezer Akwenje, and Edward Akufuadu. Kwame Nkrumah, the seat of the deep sex on the currency, was to join them later. And there are others, equally important, that we should not forget. And I pay homage to George Bagrant, R.S. Blee, Obinna Kese, J.W. DeGraff Johnson, and Francis Awono Williams, among others. Distinguished guests, Nanano, the speech the Ghanaian philosopher Dankwa made on that day deserves to be quoted liberally on a D-Lagos. He said, "Love of freedom from foreign control has always been in our blood. 870 years ago, we struck against attempts of Arabs to impose a religious slavery upon us in Ghana. We left our homes in Ghana and came down here to build a new home. But there is one thing we brought with us from ancient Ghana. We brought with us our ancient freedom. Today, the safety of that freedom is threatened. We must fight against the new domination, and we must fight with the weapons of today. Constitutional, determined, persistent, unflinching, unceasing, until the goal of freedom is attained," unquote. Dankwa captured the mood of the time and set our country on the path to independence. 4th August is truly a sacred and seminal day in the annals of the Ghanaian people. The unfolding of the story is well known. The UGCC leaders decided they needed a full-time person to run the party's affairs. They sent for the dynamic Kwame Nkrumah, and he came to join them in December 1947. Soon thereafter, on 28 February 1948, the notorious and senseless killings of 3 air servicemen, Sergeant Ajiti, Corporal Atiku, and Private Odafi Lamti occurred and sparked a nationwide revulsion against the colonial power, which undoubtedly quickened the pace of the independence movement. The Waxing Commission followed, which mapped out the steps towards our eventual attainment of independence. In 1949, on 12 June, Kwame Nkrumah broke away from the UGCC and formed his own party, the Convention's People's Party. Even as he broke away, Kwame Nkrumah remembered from whence he came and retained the word convention in the name of his new party, the CPP. Eventually, independence came, and Ghana, under the leadership of Dr. Kwame Nkrumah, became the first sub-Saharan country to gain its freedom on March 6, 1957. Dankwa had done the research and convinced himself and others that the bulk of the people that inhabit these lands migrated from the ancient kingdom of Ghana. In 1957, we lowered the British flag and we jettisoned the name Gold Coast that had been given to us and took on the name Ghana, the name of our ancestral home. The name Ghana was meant to give us a fresh start and a mark the break from colonialism. And it was also meant to give us a sense of our historical roots and the assurance that we have a history, culture, and civilization that preceded colonialism. Ladies and gentlemen, we must remember on a day like us some others who are not listed among the forefront fighters of political freedom, but who fought equally hard for our cultural integrity and the identification of who we are as Ghanaians. I pay homage to Efrimama Amo, Tata Amo, as he was fondly called. He was the composer of what easily passes as our unofficial national anthem, Yenara Asmasi. Is there a Ghanaian among us today who can sing or hear that song in whichever language, without being moved. Every Mamamo stood alone, most of the time, against what he saw as cultural domination. You did not have to wear a European cat suit to be a scholar. You could wear a fugu, kente, and above all, a locally woven fabric, and still be an educated person, he argued. He insisted, you did not have to eat foreign food because you were a scholar. And he insisted, our music was as interesting and sophisticated as any around the world. Those were radical ideas for the time. I pay homage to Philip Gbeho, the composer of our national anthem, and to Theodosia Okun, the designer of our national flag. I pay homage to Kofi Antubam, the artist who first put Ghanaian art on the map. I pay homage to Saka Akwe, the poet, writer, sculptor, a musician, who wrote the first African folklore, The Lost Fisherman. I pay tribute to J.A. Brightman, the Gonja scholar, a statesman, who wrote insightful publications about the Gonja people. I pay homage to Apollo, the poet, who immortalized the philosophy and music of the Ewe language. I pay homage to E.T. Manson, Kim Bruce, Jerry Hansen, and the others who popularized highlight, which has become an enduring identity of Ghanaian music. I pay tribute to the great musicologist, J.H. Nketia, who is a great authority on African music. I pay homage to Otunfo Prempeh, who waged a heroic, even if unsuccessful, battle against the British and retained his dignity even in exile. I pay homage to Yasantua, the woman of Velo, who led the Ashanti resistance to British imperialism. I pay homage to Nana Uforiatta I, who saw the wisdom in investing in the education of the young. Emmanuel Obechebi Lamti, Liberty Lamti, Simon Diagon Zongo, Kofi Abrifa Busia, Bafo Osei Akutu, Victor Ousu, R.R. Amponsan, Joe Apia, S.D. Amton, Modesto Apelu, Ashi Nipe, Ato Okain, and others. Our generation of Ghanaians have vindicated their stance. On 7 December 2016, the Ghanaian people exercised their sovereign franchise in a dignified and serene manner to remove an incumbent and elect a new government, and thus demonstrated again their deep attachment to the democratic values and governance. The difficult times our country went through after independence were to be replicated across the continent. The alliances with one-party states, military interventions, political theory, experimentation, and instability, and the collapse of economies with each life. I must pay homage to Professor Albert Edubuwan, the eminent historian and academic. He found his voice, spoke out, and ended a culture of silence. His courage was the inspiration that sparked the agitation for the restoration of democracy. Finally, in Ghana, a consensus emerged with the coming into being of the Fourth Republic. We have agreed on a multi-party constitutional democracy and a guarantee of individual freedoms under the rule of law. These past 24 years have been the longest period of political stability our country has enjoyed since independence, and the effects are showing a bit slowly. The pace of our development has quickened, and our self-confidence, which had been severely strained, has returned. At independence, the popular slogan was seek first the political kingdom, then all other things will be added. We assume, and indeed, we expect that rapid economic development will follow the political freedom that we achieve. Sadly, the economic dividend that was meant to accompany our freedom has still not materialized. 60 years after those hard days, too many of our people continue to wallow in unacceptable poverty. After 6 years, we have run out of excuses that it is time to set Ghana to rights and get our country to where we should be. No. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the realization of the foregoing state of affairs make the theme for this year's celebration more appropriate. That is, mobilizing for the future. The time has come for the mobilization of all available resources of the state to push for the accelerated development of our beloved country. The challenge before us is to build our economy and generate a prosperous, progressive, and dignified life for the mass of our people. Hard work, enterprise, creativity, and a consistent fight against corruption in public life will bring the transformation we seek. We will achieve these goals when we move and act as a united people. We must take pride in our delivery, in our diversity by all means. The Ghanaian must always rise above the ethnic and sectional interests. We have a bright future, and we must mobilize all our resources and all our friends here and in the Ghanaian diaspora to get that promise land faster. Fellow Ghanaians, it is turning out to be a constant refrain that on a day like us, we cannot ignore the state of our environment. We are endangering the very survival of the beautiful embraced land that our forefathers bequeathed to us. The dense forests that were a home to very trees, plants, and ferns have largely disappeared. Today, we import timber for our use, and the description of our land as a tropical forest no longer fits the reality. Our rivers and lakes are disappearing, and those that still exist are all polluted. It bears repeating that we do not own the land, but hold it in trust for generations yet unborn. We have a right to exploit the bounties of the earth and extract the minerals and even redirect the path of the river where we do not have it. To denude the land of the plants and fauna, nor poison the rivers and lakes. There is nothing we can do better to pay homage to those who fought to free us from bondage than to dedicate this 6 year of independent and diverse week to protecting our environment and regenerating the lands and water bodies. Nanaron, ladies and gentlemen, I have the confidence that we can and will achieve the dreams of our forebears. I am hopeful that we will continue to make ourselves worthy inhabitants of this land. I know that we will wear the accolade of being a Ghanaian with pride. Let's mobilize for the happy and prosperous Ghana of tomorrow, in which all of us, including our youth, our women, and the vulnerable in our society, will have equal opportunities to realize the potential and build lives of dignity. Then our independence will be meaningful. Then we will have a Ghana beyond aid. 2 months ago, the inauguration of His Excellency the President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo, he held that we renew the sacred compact that comes with being able to call yourself a citizen. I'm proud that I'm able to say without equivocation, I am a Ghanaian. Nanarong, distinguished guests, security agencies, teachers, people, ladies and gentlemen. Before I end the address, I wish to celebrate one of our senior high schools, that is Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology Senior High School. They won their 60th independent anniversary national debate competition last Friday by beating Ujong Senior High School from Koforidua. The event is in Accra. We congratulate you, KNUST Senior High School. Nananom, the same way guests, security agencies, teachers, people, ladies and gentlemen, I wish you all a happy Diamond Jubilee anniversary, and God bless you. May the Almighty bless our homeland Ghana and make her great and strong.
They will pick up their food items later. The next award goes to the best performing public GHS.
And in addition to the prize that you receive, I'm making a personal donation on behalf of the president, myself, and the people of Ashanti region, an amount of 5,000 Ghana.
Thank you, sir. The award for best performing private JHS would go to Kensington Trust School. The regional police commander to please present the award for us.
Yes, sir.
The next award is for best performing senior high school, and that goes to Kumasi Wesley Girls. They shall also receive a certificate, a plaque, and a quantity of Ghana 60 branded exercises. The award for best performing youth group goes to the SDA Adventist Youth Group. SDA Adventist Youth Group.
Thank you.
They will receive a certificate, a plaque, and a quantity of Ghana 60 branded exercise books.
Not for anybody.
The next award is for best performing cadet as this year's anniversary, and it shall go to Kumasi Technical Institute. Yaakwa Chimafu is a retired educationist, having retired from active service last year as Deputy Director of Education. He has, for the past 5 years, served on the Planning Committee for the Independence Anniversary Celebrations. And even after his retirement, he still avails himself to serve the country. Mr. Yaakwa Chimafu will receive a plaque and a citation which reads, citation presented to Yaakwa Chimafu,
an education culminated in many successful Independence Day anniversary parades. On your retirement, the committee congratulates you. We acknowledge your sacrifice and hail your work as worthy of emulation. Ghana is proud of you. The award shall please be presented by the regional minister.
Thank you very much. Please, all schools.
Yes! Act.